Another little animal we saw in the forest was the paddy melon. Now, paddy melons are lovely little macropods or members of the kangaroo family. This guy was totally in a rainforest scenario. So I'm shooting 12,800 ISO. I never shoot that normally. But hey, isn't it important to get the image? Worry about noise or grain later on. Is he eating bread there? No, he's not. He's actually eating a mushroom. Pretty cool. So to process this guy, and look at that, that's the final result. Yes, there's a bit of noise in there. I haven't taken it into Topaz yet, which can drop the noise further. Lightroom's noise reduction capability is also very good. So that's what I always start with, is using Lightroom. But let's have a look. We'll go develop, reset, and there's our original photograph. Now, if we consider that as is, I'm pretty happy with that. But as I mentioned, if you zoom in, you'll actually see that there's a fair bit of noise or grain in the photograph. Hit F again, and now I'm going to process it. So I'm in develop, I go to vibrance new, and vibrance new, remember, we'll do contrast, shadows, bit of vibrance, and sharpen the image for me. And nowadays, I just add a tiny bit of texture as well. In this particular image, I'm going to target the surrounding area from the subject. So to do that, I'm going to go to the mask tool. I'm going to go to select subject. It's going to do that. And again, it'll do a fantastic job. Look at that. But I'm going to go back to my palette over here, and I've got invert here. I click invert, and now it's going to target the area outside of the key subject. I then go to exposure, and I'm going to drop that down a little bit. Okay, and shadows, I might drop down a little also, just a bit. Okay. I click done, and now I've got my image or my key subject looking fantastic, and I have my image looking very interesting. Now, I've got a little bit of someone's foot or something there. I can either take that out with the clone tool, or in this case, I'm going to just crop it out. Now, if I hold the shift key down, it will retain proportion. So it won't move in a funny way at all. But if I don't hold the shift key down, I can vary how I'm going to crop it. So shift key, lock, retain proportion. I'm going to just take out that little bit of a problem there. I'm using thirds still. So the paddy melon is nicely balanced there. Click done. And my final thing I would look at doing in this case is coming down to detail and using this tool here, masking. So if I hold my option or alt key down, click on that, it shows all white. That says it's processing or affecting every pixel in the image. If I now move this across, it will now start to show black areas and white areas. Now the white area, remember, says it's sharpening all of the image. As I progressively move this across, and I'm going to stop at about this point here, about the 40, I find 40 to 50 works really well. The white area is the sharpened pixel information, and the black area, which traditionally shows more of the noise or grain, is not being sharpened. So the noise and grain in those areas will be limited, and that's the whole idea of that masking. Fantastic feature. Release. And I'll now have an image much, much better in regards to noise or grain in that area. Now, when you consider that shot at 12,800 ISO with a 51 megapixel sensor, I'm blown away by that. And the ability to handhold that, get a sharp result, really, that's probably one of the best paddy melon shots I've ever taken. That just shows the technology working at its best, but also the visualization and post-visualization aspect, where I've processed the image really smartly for a great result.